Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at how to determine the substitution of a double bond. So a double bond is two carbons that are connected to one another through a sigma bond and a pi bond. And then remaining are going to be two additional bonds that each carbon can make. So there's a total of four spots, let's say, on a double bond that can be substitutions. So anything that is not a hydrogen atom would be defined as a substitution across that double bond. So let's say that we can calculate this just doing a simple calculation. There are four total spots. If we subtract the number of hydrogens on the double bond, that tells us the substitution of that double bond. Here is a line angle depiction of an alkene, and I have one methyl group coming off of that alkene. I don't have my hydrogens drawn on because I'm doing a line angle depiction, but if it helps you, you can certainly draw the hydrogens on just to keep track of them. So I'm going to draw the same molecule over here on the right, but this time I'm going to show all the hydrogens that are assumed in a line angle formula. So it's a little easier to see now that I have three hydrogens. So in doing this calculation, I have four total spots, right? Four places for bonds, one, two, three, and four, coming off of those carbons that are part of the double bond. And I have three hydrogens on this particular example. So four minus three is one. This is a mono-substituted double bond. So mono for just one thing that is not a hydrogen atom. So here I have a series of molecules. These molecules are isomers of one another. They have the same molecular formula, so the same number of carbons and hydrogens, but their connectivity or spatial orientation is different. But all of these are examples of disubstituted alkenes. So it doesn't matter where the substituents are across the double bond or their relationship to one another. It's just how many substituents there are on the double bond. So again, they're all in line angle formula. I'm going to go through and add my hydrogens just so that we can see more easily how many there are on each. Okay, but each of these examples has two hydrogen atoms on it. So there are four total spots. They each have two hydrogen atoms. Remember, that's what we're subtracting just for ease. That equals two. This is a disubstituted double bond. So here I have two more examples, again, both in line angle formula. I'm using methyls as my substituents, but it could be anything that's not a hydrogen. So it could be an ethyl, a propyl, it could be a halogen. Anything that's not a hydrogen would be considered a substitution. Typically, you're going to see some sort of alkyl group. But just for the ease of sort of getting the point across, I'm only using methyls here. So I filled in my H on the left-hand side. There was one spot that didn't appear to have anything on it. That's the assumed hydrogen that we don't draw in line angle formula. And then on the right hand side, I have every spot occupied by a methyl group. So again, if I do my quick calculation, 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. This is a tri-substituted double bond. And then 4 minus 0 is equal to 4. There's no hydrogens on this molecule on the right. And when we have 4, we call that a tetra-substituted double bond. So those are the four different types of substitution you can see across a double bond with respect to the groups that are coming off of the carbons that are part of a double bond. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends, and I'll see you next time.